Hi, I'm Craig, and this is a two-way video, and I'm watching you. And this is Mental Floss on YouTube. Today, I'm gonna answer bored during school's big question, how does a two-way mirror work? You guys have probably seen tons of two-way mirrors in cop shows. Usually, someone is being interrogated inside a room containing a mirror, but people outside that room can see into it through that very same mirror. Confusingly, two-way mirrors are also known as one-way mirrors. What? I'll let you think about that annoying part of the English language while we roll the intro. Let's get started. Before answering this question, I should quickly explain that I have never been arrested. I just did research. Actually, I didn't even do that. Meredith did that. But let's explain how a regular mirror works. A mirror is usually glass covering something like a sheet of silver or aluminum. When light hits that sheet, it bounces off of it, and you usually see a very handsome bearded man in there. Well, at least I do. A two-way mirror also contains a sheet of metal, but it's a much thinner sheet. So light still bounces off of it and reflects on one side, but that only accounts for half the light. The other half continues through the mirror. So let's say there's a person on each side of a two-way mirror that separates two rooms. The creepy weirdo who wants to see through the mirror will need ideal lighting conditions. The person only seeing their reflection needs to be in a very bright space. And the person looking through the mirror should be in a darker room. If lighting is similar in both places, the two people will actually be able to see each other. Basically, because it's a mirror, it all boils down to light. You're not going to find a two-way mirror that works all the time. People who design things like interrogation rooms need to adjust the lighting accordingly. Very light inside and dark outside. Should we be telling you this? Of course, I'm not advocating the amateur use of two-way mirrors, because they have the potential to be super creepy when they're not necessary. That's what the cops told me when I was making them. So, I'm going to teach you how to tell if a mirror is two-way. One option is to create a really dark space around your eyes and press them right up to the mirror. By creating dark lighting, you're probably able to tell whether there's another side to the mirror. And if not, you just get a good up-close look at yourself. And if you love yourself like me, that's a good thing. Another way is to observe the mirror. If it looks like it's embedded into the wall, that's cause for concern. But if it's just hanging up in front of the wall, you're probably in the clear. Thanks for watching Mental Floss on YouTube, which is made with the help of these nice interrogators. If you have a big question of your own that you'd like answered, leave it below in the comments. See you next week.